The doctor said that I won't live for more than 40 days. And you can imagine how upsetting it would be for a family or for parents, especially, you know, when it's the case of the firstborn. And that's how I got my name Javed. So my father says that he was so upset and he was so frustrated, he didn't know what to do. So the best thing that he could think of was to give me my name, Javed, which means immortal one who does not die. So the joke in the family is that it worked and I'm still around. I wanted to be a journalist, and my degree is in mass communication with a specialization in journalism. I was also lucky or privileged to get a scholarship and was able to go to the US from where I did my degree. And then I come back to Delhi, and to my horror I realize that for the next 6 months I was jobless. For the next 6 months, I went to newspaper after newspaper after newspaper, magazine after magazine after magazine, and none of them would want to touch me with a barge pole because they were not looking at my degree, they were not looking at my qualifications, they were looking at my wheelchair. Quite by chance, I had the opportunity of meeting Mrs. Gandhi, Mrs. Sonia Gandhi, and somehow the discussion came around disability. And that's when she asked me if I knew about the Rajiv Gandhi Foundation, and I didn't know much. And that's when I learned that they're working in 5 areas, and one of them is the area of disability, which I just could not believe because at that time nobody in India was looking at disability with the seriousness that it deserved. And to my horror and surprise, I realized that they were offering me to set up the unit and to head the unit. Now that offer was obviously too good to be true and too good to be resisted. If I get into the area of disability, especially at a platform which is so sort of exclusive as the Rajiv Gandhi Foundation, I'd be able to do so much for people like me and so much for things which have made me angry in this country. And one journalist less is not going to affect the world of journalism, or you know, the newspapers or the magazines are not going to stop selling or publishing. So with that crazy thought, I gave up journalism, entered the area of disability, and the rest has been a long, fruitful, extremely self-fulfilling, satisfying, exciting journey. My contention is that India has systemically neglected disability, as a result of which we have the situation that we have. Almost none of our schools are accessible. There's not one university in India where a person like me on a wheelchair can go and study with safety and dignity. Our public spaces are all inaccessible. The law says, the 11th plan of the Planning Commission says, that 3% resources of every ministry, every department must be allocated to the well-being and to the rights of people with disabilities. Why is that not happening? My contention is that the nation is still not serious. We are talking about disability a lot more than before. There are a lot of well-meaning people. Politician also talks about disability. Especially when they are out of power, they talk about disability more. When they are in power, they forget all about it. But we still have a long way ahead of us. And I can say it with some amount of conviction that even though it has now been almost 20 years since I've been working in this space, even today, or every morning that I wake up, I still feel as fresh, I still feel as excited, I still feel as motivated as my first day at job way back in 1991 or 1992.